Well, first I have to thank you for inviting me. The breakfast was quite nice. Second, I have prepared a PowerPoint presentation of 44 slides. That's not a joke. I can give it to you. And I have even updated the data I have about the arbitration, ICC arbitration in Latin America and in Europe. If you want, I can show you, because though the case, the subject was future prospects, I am not futurologist, so I cannot predict what will happen. But I have, looking at the past, you can guess what will be the future. As far as the number of cases, parties, and arbitrators, then the sort of political problems, that is, institutions not believing in arbitration, that would be, for instance, the European Union, that is a sort of a dark cloud that is somewhere in between, that might affect the future. But if you allow me, I mean, I will not use the 44 slides, so I will use just some slides. And if you don't mind, I stand because I cannot look backwards, but I'll do it. Just to know that ICC is in Paris, now it's in Paris, but also in Sao Paulo, Hong Kong, New York, Abu Dhabi, and Singapore, so that is not the place of arbitration, it's the place where the institution is. But let's go to the statistics. You cannot see anything at all, but it's nice, the colors at least. Switzerland, United Kingdom, Germany, Italy, France, and Spain. We start in 1992 and we end in 2017. So we can see the trends as a place of arbitration. And if you look at the place of arbitration, obviously, which are the places where they have more arbitrations? This is the past, this is the future. Spain, for instance, was Spain. Spain is this one. Spain was very low at this line, and it's still very low as place of arbitration. We'll change that in the other cases. But if you look at the other ones, for instance, United Kingdom and Switzerland, the anomaly, United Kingdom and Switzerland is the blue one. And then Germany and France are on top. That means that people, when they decide where to go, they go to these places. But we are growing, and we are not in such a bad position so far. Parties, the same, Switzerland, United Kingdom, Germany, Italy, France, and Spain, from 1993 to 2017. Oops. Good. Here, this is Spain, and Spain, if you take a look, it has grown a lot. From 1993 to now, we are sometimes over 100 parties in arbitration. We have a jump over Italy. I don't know the Italian guys, they will be happy, but Italy was very far away ahead of Spain, and now Italy is below Spain. Usually, France and Germany are on top of us, but then if you take a look at Switzerland, United Kingdom, they are below us too. So it is very funny that normally parties from United Kingdom and Switzerland are less than arbitrators, while in Spain it's the opposite. There are more parties than arbitrators. It's true. The people believe that arbitrators from the United Kingdom and Switzerland are better. I don't know if that's true, but that's what they believe. The same again, Switzerland, United Kingdom, Germany, Italy, France, and Spain. As the figures will be given to you, you can check the data afterwards. And it's based on the bulletin of the court published every year. And here again, Spain was very low, but again, we have made a little sorpasso to Italy. And the others are ahead of us. As I said, Switzerland and United Kingdom are very far away from where we are. And if we compare with Latin America, I have used Brazil, Chile, Argentina, Mexico, Costa Rica, El Salvador, Panama, Guatemala, Venezuela, Colombia, Peru, and Uruguay. Many of them have zero, Salvador, for instance. Let's compare the two biggest ones, that is Brazil and Mexico, and it is clear that this was, places of arbitration. As places of arbitration, Brazil has grown a lot, because even ICC has created an office in Sao Paulo to avoid paying taxes in Brazil that would prevent them from using ICC arbitration. But then the other countries that have a very nice place is Mexico, for instance. The others are very low, between 5 and 0, but Brazil and Mexico have Brazil more than 30 places of arbitration, and that means not only Sao Paulo and Rio, but also other places in arbitration. I mean, there are 5 places in Brazil where they have had ICC arbitration.
And Costa Rica as well, no?
Yes, Costa Rica has grown a lot, it's true. Maybe they believe that Costa Rica is a reliable place for doing business or doing arbitration. As far as parties, again, here the two biggest ones are Brazil and Mexico. Argentina is more or less stable, but the others are in a very lower places. This is Brazil. Brazil is over 100 parties lately, and then Mexico has gone a lot and then gone down, but all the others are very low. So, but in any case, you see that the trend is growing. So if I had to predict anything at all, it would be that the future is at least hopeful. As far as arbitrators, again, Mexico and Brazil, but there are also some Argentinians are the leading ones. Brazil and Mexico. They are not about 100, but around 60. All the others are below that figure. And I have more figures, but if you compare the number of cases, as far as you see, which is the area of the world that has more cases? Obviously, Europe. From 1993 to 2014, Europe has doubled. But if you take a look at, for instance, Latin America has multiplied per 10. So where is the place where ICC arbitration is growing? Well, Europe, but the place where it is growing more is in Latin America. That may also explain why they have created this office in, so this is Europe, and Latin America is this one. It has grown a lot. And well, that's it. The other 44 pages, is, to you, if you want to use them at the end, I don't know if I have answered your question, but at least, as I had prepared the PowerPoint, I wanted to use it.